Golf course superintendents are all about efficiency. Today we're talking about herbicide mixtures and reducing injury to Bermudagrass.
The herbicide Pylex is an effective post-emergence product for goosegrass. However, Pylex is known to injure desirable Bermudagrass. This research is looking at ways to reduce herbicide injury from Pylex on hybrid Bermudagrass cultivars by assessing herbicide mixtures. This research was conducted on two hybrid Bermudagrass cultivars in Knoxville, Tennessee. Latitude 36 Bermudagrass was sprigged 3 months ago. A second trial was initiated on fully mature Tahoma 31 Bermudagrass. For the remainder of this video, you will see Latitude 36 plots, which were treated 10 days ago on the left side of the screen. You'll then see Tahoma 31 plots, which were treated 21 days ago on the right side of the screen. These are non-treated control plots in both Latitude 36 and Tahoma 31. This means that these plots have not received any herbicide throughout the entirety of the trial. We will use these plots to compare the amount of injury we see from other herbicide treatments. These plots were treated with half a fluid ounce per acre of Pylex. Pylex is a group 27 HPPD inhibiting herbicide with the common name of tapramazone. HPPD inhibiting herbicides are known for their bleaching effects to Bermudagrass. As you can see here, 10 days after treatment to Latitude 36 Bermudagrass, we observe severe bleaching. However, 21 days after treatment in Tahoma 31 Bermudagrass, the turf grass has fully recovered. This application of Pylex did result in increased injury compared to an application of Speedzone alone. These plots were treated with 4 pints per acre of Speedzone. Speedzone is a mixture of carfentrazone, 2,4-D, MCPP, and dicamba. Carfentrazone is a group 14 PPO inhibiting herbicide, while 2,4-D, MCPP, and dicamba are group 4 synthetic auxin herbicides. Speedzone is produced by PBI Gordon and is labeled for post-emergence goosegrass control. 10 days after treatment on Latitude 36 Bermudagrass, you'll see that there is some injury to Bermudagrass from the application of Speedzone. However, 21 days after treatment in Tahoma 31 Bermudagrass, the turf grass is fully recovered and exhibits no injury from an application of Speedzone. These plots were treated with a mixture of Speedzone at 4 pints per acre and Pylex at half a fluid ounce. The purpose of assessing these herbicides in mixture was to see if the combination would reduce injury to Bermudagrass compared to that of an application of Pylex alone. Although some injury was observed 10 days after treatment to Latitude 36 Bermudagrass, the injury was far less than that of an application of Pylex alone. 21 days after treatment to Tahoma 31 Bermudagrass, the turf grass has completely recovered and shows no sign of injury. We believe that Speedzone and Pylex in mixture can be a promising way to post-emergently control goosegrass while minimizing Bermudagrass injury. We are also assessing other rates of Speedzone and Pylex in combination to see what the optimum rates are to reduce injury while maintaining goosegrass efficacy. Other trials have shown that Speedzone and Pylex in mixture actually results in equal to or greater control of goosegrass than an application of Pylex alone. These plots were treated with a mixture of Sencor at 6 ounces per acre and Pylex at 0.25 fluid ounces per acre. This herbicide mixture has been shown to reduce Bermudagrass injury similar to mixtures of Speedzone and Pylex. Extensive research on this mixture has been conducted by the lab group of Dr. Sean Askew at Virginia Tech. Here in Tennessee, on Latitude 36 and Tahoma 31 Bermudagrass, we see very little or no injury to turf grass 10 and 21 days after treatment.